The beginning, I thought it was a really good idea. Right now, I'm second guessing that idea, but I'm having fun with it. And it's been a lot of fun, and I've actually really enjoyed doing the training and the dieting, maybe not so much, but the training. I don't know, I just wanted something. I wanted to say, look what I did. And I'm almost 40 and I did it. I just wanted that something, just something in my life to say, you know, to show my kids, to show whoever, just to say I did it. That was the big reason for it.
We started this whole process probably about 4 years ago. In this four-year process, she decided that she was going to compete. She didn't say when, up until about 3 months ago.
We're almost there. I have to get there. I have to shower and shave. And then I have to go for my first tan. And then after I'm done with my tanning, I have to go sign in, register, get my number. And then they're going to have like a meeting of some sort afterwards. And that's pretty much it for the night. It's going to be a long night and an early morning. We just made it. We're in London, Ontario. We're at the hotel right now. We have to get everything out of the car and get into the room, and it's becoming more real now. I'm starting to freak out just that little bit more because we're like almost there, but I'm excited and this should be fun. We're late, and oh my god, I'm gonna freak. Yeah, no, I'm having a hard time right now. This is just too much, and it's making me kind of cuckoo right now. This is my stress level right now. I need two of these things to survive, or else I beat the crap out of him. Oh, I just mix flavors too. And a toonie?
Yeah.
And a loonie?
Good enough, yeah. It should be.
Should be good, eh?
After meeting, plus we've got a few girls to get through too that can get.
You said 35.
Okay.
You need more?
No. No. If we go on a break from 5:30 until 8, we won't be back.
Change.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
I'm not allowed.
I give you $235 puff. Yeah. Don't lose that one.
Don't lose the puff.
And Pam's gonna book you in based on the you know when your hair makeup is.
We're here at the DoubleTree Hilton. Chris is getting her tanning done. We're just waiting for her outside the tanning suite.
All done. I have to go for a second coat tomorrow at 4:30. It was freezing. Holy crap. Freezing, standing in a room with a bunch of naked women. It was, you know, it was kind of fun. A little bit. Hey, what are you doing? Holy shit. I shouldn't do this. I'm trying to walk and look at the phone and type text messages. Yeah, no.
Not a good idea for you.
I'm going like this and I can feel my body. I need to go sleep. We are going to register. And then after registration, they have a meeting, which is at like 7:30, I think. And I don't know how long that's going to be.
All right, you registered online?
Yes.
What's your last name? Murphy. Yeah.
Thank you.
So, what's your last name?
Murpaw.
Heard it?
Murpaw and the PAW.
Is it just the one class?
She's actually competing in two classes. It's the figure open and the figure masters. We started actually show prep about 3 months ago, but this has been in the works for about 4 years. We had to make sure she had the right amount of protein and the right amount of carbohydrates. Thank you.
As your bony fingers close around me, long and spindly death becomes me. Heaven, can you see what I see?
Hey, you pale and sickly child, you're deaf. That's called a relaxed pose. There's nothing f***ing relaxed about that f***ing pose. I gotta do it from both freaking sides too. Relax my ass. I'm very nervous about tomorrow. Just so many thoughts going through my head right now. Just thinking of everything. It's very nerve-wracking, scared, excited, all the emotions right now. It's insane. The one thing though that's helped me kind of get through all this and get over that hump of fear and not wanting to do it and then doing it, and people made comments on my Facebook, people sent me messages, you know, telling me I look great and good luck and you can do this. But there was one that really, really stood out to me, and it's from Mark Lee, and he said, "Hard work puts you where good luck can find you. Being in the condition you're in now, you've already won. Now it's a matter of showing it to the world." Hearing something like that, it just kind of gives you that little kick in the ass to do it and just go with it, and whatever happens, happens. Inspired from Judy English, She says, wow, what a great accomplishment. The trophies are really nice. Display them with pride. Well done. From my cousin, Liette, she says, way to go, Chris. I'm happy you stuck with it. As you can see, it was worth it in the end. You look happy in this pic. One from my bestest friend, Vicky, which made me, it kind of choked me up a little bit. Hard work, determination, and believing in yourself can guide you in anything you want to do. The people that chirp negativity in your ear are poison to your life and will never allow you to gain. You didn't only win these trophies, you gained your life back. They weren't won, they were earned, and I couldn't be prouder. One, I guess, from your friend Michelle. Said, excellent job. I can't imagine the work and tears you put in, and proving something to yourself is the greatest reward. Another one from Joanne. She says, wow, wow, and just wow. You look incredible. So happy for you. One from Gita. She says, congratulations, Chris. I wish I could have been there cheering for you. You deserve this. You will always be my... You have to put this on film, right? You'll always be my biggest inspiration. I just want to say thank you to everybody who supported me, who sent me messages and everything like that. I just want to say thank you. The support and the love that I got from everybody really, really helped me get through some of the rough patches. Like I said before, there was days where I just wanted to give up, but the messages and the support from them just got me over that and kept me going, and I really, really appreciate it all, and thank you very, very much. She's just a girl and she's on fire, hotter than a fantasy, lonely like a highway. She's living in a world and it's on fire, filled with catastrophe, but she knows she can fly away.